Praise the Lord. Once again, we come to you with a word from God. We say good morning to you. We're happy that you're here to join us. And we just come lift up the name of Jesus. And we just thank him for keeping us all week. We're blessed that God is our Father. And we thank him for everything that he has done in our life. What a marvelous God that we serve. He is an excellent God.
Oh, yes, he is.
Yes,
and this is a marvelous day, a wonderful day that God has blessed us to come back with the Word of God. And I'm just so excited. So I want you to get ready and get your Bibles, get your pens, and just sit down and begin to take notes. Yes. Let's follow as we go through the scriptures, because we're going to talk about the prayer of faith today. So just in a few seconds, we'll be right back with today's message.
Amen.
Well, praise the Lord. We're going to talk about the prayer of faith today, and that is so important to us as Christians. So as we go into the Word of God, I want you to prepare your heart and be open to hear what the Spirit of God has to say. And you know, we can never exhaust all the subjects and everything that's in the Bible, in the Word of God. I don't know it all. Sugar, she don't know it all. You don't know it all. None of us know it all, but we have to continue to search the Scriptures and just follow as we go through it. And it's a privilege that we can come around the Word of God after an entire week of, you know, doing our normal activities and doing everything we have to do. It's good to just settle down on a day to just hear the Word of God preached, and having us all come together from every part of the world to hear the gospel. And that's why I thank God so much for technology, that we can get this message of faith and hope in the gospel of Jesus Christ around the world, because it's God's will that every man be saved and woman be saved, be born again, and to hear the good news of Jesus Christ. I mean, thank God, the good news of Christ is good news. It's always good news, and it's never stale news. It's never yesterday's news, but it's always good news, present news, and it's the Word of God. Amen.
Amen.
So we're going to talk about the prayer of faith today, and as we talk about this, I want you to understand that we don't just pray as Christians, but God has given us an order how we ought to pray and the spirit that we ought to pray in. And I found out that if you don't know correctly how to do a thing, then you will misuse it, abuse it, or you'll become reckless with it, and you won't get the results that it's been designed for you to have. So when we get the Word of God around prayer, we can understand prayer.
Yeah.
And years ago, when they would have prayer in church, and I was a lot younger, and they would make us to pray, have us to come to church and pray. And I didn't like prayer a whole lot. I didn't like going to prayer. I felt prayer was boring, and it was just something that was like punishment, or I just didn't enjoy it.
Right.
And then you would hear people howling and wailing and beating on seats and chairs and screaming and all of this. And I just didn't understand that. And I just couldn't wait till it was over. Mm-hmm. That's why I was kind of understanding why when Jesus had his disciples to pray and they all fell asleep because, you know, things they're not excited about, you just sleep on it, you know, because they didn't see the importance of it. But now that I'm matured and learned the essence of prayer and the importance of it, I don't want to leave it out.
No.
Amen. Amen. Now we're going to go from James today, chapter 5, and let's start at verse 14.
Okay. And it says, "Is any sick among you? Let him call for the elders of the church and let them pray over him, anointing him with oil in the name of the Lord.
So we thank God for that, right? Mm-hmm. So, you know, if any sick among you, you call for the mature ones, call for the elders of the church, right. and we ought to do that. That's good right. to do. Mm-hmm. You know, you need help, you call for it. You know, you call for the elders, you call for prayer, whether you call it from your house or by phone, or you in church and you just call and say, I need prayer. Mm-hmm. And it's scripture to do that, to have hands laid on you, mm-hmm. to have someone pray over you. And especially, you know, when you're facing a sickness or a disease or any situation, and when the elders here, the mature ones, those that are mature in the Lord, those that are in leadership, he is talking about here, have them to pray over you. So we see it don't necessarily have to be the pastor praying over you.
Or the deacons. Right. It's the mature ones that know how to pray in faith.
Yes, right. Yes. Mm-hmm. So that we want the elders to pray.
The elders to pray.
Right. We want the elders to pray. Mm-hmm. We want them to pray. And that's God's order. If you're sick, you know, you can pray for yourself too. Mm-hmm. You know, but scripturally right here, he is saying you can call for help. You know, call for the troops, call right. them to come in.
That's right.
And let us all mm-hmm. get together and we pray. So we establish that. And then it says also, let them anoint with oil.
Oil, right. In the name of the Lord.
Right. Let them anoint them in the name mm-hmm. of the Lord, in the name of Jesus. They anoint them with oil, right?
Right.
In the name of the Lord. And we had oil laid placed on us mm-hmm. even today. You know, we've been anointed with oil. And that's scripturally do because the oil actually represents the Holy Spirit
right.
or the anointing.
Right.
You know, mm-hmm. so it's okay to have the oil, and I'm not stressing the oil here, but the oil has its place mm-hmm. for what it represents.
Right.
So we anoint with oil, and many of you have been anointed with oil, olive oil or Pompeian oil, the kind of oil they had in church. They would anoint you with oil, and even in the Old Testament, when they would anoint a king or a person for office, they would anoint him with oil, mm-hmm. representing the anointing of God, right. the presence of God, you know. So that's mm-hmm. it's good for what it represents exactly. and what it stands for, right?
Right.
So we see here, so we anoint with oil, that is scriptural. And then it said, like you said earlier, in the scripture says as well, in the name of the Lord.
In the name of the Lord.
And we know what that name is. We know who that name mm-hmm. is. That's Jesus, right?
Jesus, yeah.
So we anoint, we do this, we call for the elders of the church, and we anoint them with oil mm-hmm. in the name of the Lord. Now, this 15th verse is the conjunction.
And the prayer of faith shall save the sick, and the Lord shall raise him up. And if he have committed sins, they shall be forgiven him.
And that's a lot, Jay, right there, right? Mm-hmm. Even how you just start the first same verse.
Right. The prayer and faith.
Mm-hmm. The prayer and faith.
That's right. You have to come and pray in faith that and believe that God's going to heal.
Yes.
That's right. Don't come in doubt. Come in faith.
Come in faith. Mm-hmm. So that's the prayer of faith.
Right.
Mm-hmm. So don't come in doubt. So the prayer, so it's not just the prayer that saves the sick, but it's the prayer what?
The prayer of faith.
It's the prayer of faith.
So save the sick.
So that's what we're talking about, the prayer mm-hmm. of faith.
That's right.
The prayer of faith.
You got to have faith.
Yes. The prayer mm-hmm. of faith. So, you know, and a lot of times we said, let's call, Pastor Don, you did say that they're to call for the elders. Mm-hmm. Yes, we do call for the elders, but he said, and, right?
Right.
So these elders ought to be and should be people of faith.
That's right.
You don't just want prayer over you.
You don't want somebody come praying over you that don't even believe that what they're praying for is going to happen.
Exactly
right.
So.
Right.
Just going through the motions.
Just going through the motions.
You know, we're going to pray over you mm-hmm. because we're elders. Okay, you know, you're an elder, but now you're going to have to pray. But I want Deacon so-and-so or someone else to pray over me because he prays long.
Oh, you're the loudest.
Oh, the loudest.
Right. Right.
He's loudest, right, because you think loud means powerful.
Right.
It means like, you know, you're strong. It's a powerful mm-hmm. prayer because he can really pray the house down or he sounds strong or even with just eloquent speech.
Right.
You know, you call that one, you know, to pray mm-hmm. because he sounds good and when he prays, we just like to hear him pray. Right. But if there's no faith in there,
that's right.
There's no change for your life.
For
there's
your life,
no,
that's right. Because he's not even believing what he said.
No.
He's going through the motion, like you said.
Through the motion.
Mm-hmm.
They call me to pray, so I'm going to pray something
right,
over
right.
him.
Yeah,
you know,
right.
and when your life is at stake and you want to be mm-hmm. delivered from something,
that's right.
you don't have time for a show. Or performance, mm-hmm. or someone just carrying on, but you want to be delivered and healed, and right. you want this sickness or disease to be off of you.
That's right.
Right?
Right. So you want that person who's praying over you, praying the promise that God said about your healing.
Yes.
And believe it in faith.
So he'd have to stay, it, definitely, he had to know what the promises are.
That's right. He had to know what the promises are.
But it have to be in faith.
Right.
So I don't care if it's, I don't care how long the person been in the church. I don't care if they have a collar. I'm not even around their neck as a priest or whatever. That's not the prayer that he's talking about that makes it effective. Mm-hmm. But it's the prayer of faith.
The prayer of faith.
So faith has to be instituted in this prayer.
That's right.
And I think that's the thing that that James is emphasizing here.
Right.
And the prayer of faith shall save the sick.
That's right.
The prayer of faith. The prayer of faith, you know, shall save the sick. I used to just be so inclined to get everybody to just pray for me. Just pray for me. Right. I'm with this Caulfield. Just pray for me.
Yeah.
You know, and they mean well.
Right. Amen. Because we didn't know back then. We didn't know no better. We just wanted somebody to pray.
Just pray.
Even if it just made us feel good. Just pray.
Just pray. Amen. Right. Even make you just feel good.
Right. And you believe in that person more than so. You believe that God, you know, faith. And whatever that person say, you just believe what he said. But no, he has to pray in faith.
In faith, if there's no faith, mm-hmm. there's no power in that mm-hmm. prayer. That is not gonna it's not mm-hmm. gonna work, folks.
That's what, no.
It's not gonna come to pass. Mm-hmm. It's not gonna carry out what you are looking forward to carry out.
Right.
If there's no faith in it, I mean, why would I talk about something I don't even believe myself?
That's right.
So God moves by faith. He functions from faith. Hebrews 11:6 says, without faith, it's impossible to please God.
Right.
And he that cometh to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. Mm-hmm. So the prayer of faith is so important. And a lot of times we may be selective about who we want to pray for us,
right.
And we should be.
Mm-hmm.
But our respective persons should not be the color of their skin, or male or female,
right.
Or their status, or their mm-hmm. position mm-hmm. in church. But it should be faith. We should respect the faith they have.
That's right.
I want the person who prays in faith.
That's right.
The one I want praying for me. I don't care if it's a child or a little teenager that may not be sitting up on the roster.
That's right. It don't have to be the person that's sitting on that front row.
No, it don't have to be the front row.
No.
Man or woman.
Or even they've been with the church long.
No. But you want someone who prays in faith. Who can release faith.
Mm-hmm.
That can release faith.
Right.
And get this thing lifted off of me.
That's right.
See? So he says, and the prayer of faith shall save the sick.
And the Lord shall raise him up.
And the Lord shall raise him up. Because now,
right.
God won't raise him up or do any raising until faith is released.
Right.
See, because the scripture here in Matthew chapter 21. Let's go there a second. And some say, well, if I holler long, if I just scream and all of that, then, you know, then God's going to move. Not necessarily so. And I know there's some, and I'm not trying to be critical or anything, but there are some people who feels that they'll be heard by their much saying. He said in Matthew 6 that a lot of the Pharisees, they thought because of their long, repetitious prayers and because they prayed long,
right.
repeating the same thing over and over again,
right.
that impressed God.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it may impress a crowd, but you're not there for the crowd to be impressed. You're not there to impress the person. You want the person delivered. And you want them healed and set free.
Right.
So you want faith released, and you want God to answer.
That's right. Because God answered his promise. Whatever he promised,
yes.
he will answer, but we just have to believe it in faith.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Yeah, exactly.
That's right.
Matthew 21.
Even if it don't look like it.
Even if it doesn't look like it at all.
Even if it don't look like
that's
it.
And that's how faith works.
Right. Just believe.
Now, yeah. Then look at Matthew 21, 22.
And all things whatsoever ye shall ask in prayer, believing ye shall receive.
All things.
All things.
Whatsoever ye shall ask in prayer,
mm-hmm.
and believing. So you're not just asking in prayer, but all things you shall ask in prayer, believing.
Believing
you shall receive.
Right.
Not just what you ask in prayer, but all things you ask in prayer, believing you shall receive. So we see here that faith is very important concerning our asking. You don't just ask and holler out and blurt out. You have to believe what you're asking will come to pass, and believe that God is able to do exactly what you just prayed or asked, and believe that he will raise the sick.
That's right.
And raise them up. So when you pray the prayer of faith, you pray the scripture. You pray the word of God. So Father, you just declare in your word that the prayer of faith will save the sick, and you would raise them up. So therefore, in Jesus' name, I'm asking them to be raised up from this condition,
that's right,
this sickness. Mm-hmm. And I release my faith in what you said. And I thank you that they are recovering. They are raised up. They are healed. They are free. I declare that. I speak that. And I'm releasing faith in that. Mm-hmm. See, so I don't have to be there talking about your feelings, or we don't have to go through thing of praying about how you feel, how long you've been sick, or agonizing, or trying to con God, or trying to pray and beg God. See, begging God is not faith. He didn't say, whatever you beg me for, you shall receive. Whatever you ask in prayer, believing, you shall receive. So we're going to have to release faith in our asking as we pray. You're going to have to believe what you're praying come to pass.
That's right.
So this scripture here has always been special to me in all things in Matthew 21:22, and all things whatsoever you shall ask in prayer, believing.
That's right.
Believing, you shall receive. Mm-hmm. So if I ask something of you and I don't believe you're really going to do it, then it's very hard for me to have confidence while I'm asking. Mm-hmm. So since I don't believe you're going to do it, then maybe I'm going to try to get you to do it.
Right.
Maybe if I do this, I'll get you to do it. If I can just do this or sacrifice or do something or impress you, you know, you're not, God is not moved apart from faith. Mm-hmm. You're long praying and you think I stay up all night. That's not going to get it. I think if I give up 20 meals, that's maybe that'll get it. Right. Well, Pastor, you saying you shouldn't fast. I didn't say you shouldn't fast. But if you're not fasting in faith, and if you don't release faith with the fasting, right, you just went hungry.
See? That's what went on eight.
You just went on and ate you a good meal. So what I'm saying, I'm not minimizing the things we do, but it has to be girded in faith.
That's right.
And if it's not of faith, it's not going to work. Mm-hmm. So the prayer of faith will save the sick, and the Lord God, not us, God will raise the people up. He will heal them. He will deliver them. So I release my faith when I pray, and I release my faith in what God has said, mm-hmm, especially since I just read it. So I release my faith in that. And as a result, that connection is made. Mm-hmm. See, and once you connect with God through faith, as you pray and then you ask him, he said, you'll have it.
That's right. You'll have it.
You'll receive it. Mm-hmm. It'll come to pass. Now, in the book of James, mm-hmm, chapter 1, and he talks about that here in the first chapter, verse 5 and 6. James 1:5.
If any of you lack wisdom, let him ask of God, that giveth to all men liberally, mm-hmm, and upbraideth not, and it shall be given him.
6th verse.
But let him ask in faith, nothing waving, for he that waveth is like a wave of the sea, driven with the wind and tossed.
Now we see that right there. If you lack anything, this man here, if you lack wisdom, if you lack understanding, if you have lack in your life in any area, mm-hmm, you go to God. See, if any man lack wisdom, right?
Right.
Let him ask of God.
That's right.
You lack peace? Ask God. You lack direction? Ask God.
That's fine.
So you go to God. Mm-hmm. See, you go to him and ask him. Ask him. Right? And as you ask him, nothing wavering. Right? See? Mm-hmm. See, if any man like would let him, nothing wavering.
But you got to ask in faith.
But you have to ask in faith.
That's right. Ask in faith that he'll believe, that he'll do what you ask.
That's what it means.
That's right.
Say nothing wavering, mm-hmm, you know. I mean, he said, you got to believe it, but let him ask in faith.
That's right.
Don't just come to me asking, is what God is saying. Mm-hmm. Well, Pastor, how can I ask? How do I know if I'm in faith or not? Well, right, I can listen to what you're saying. Mm-hmm. If you're saying, you know, well, Lord, I hope you heal me. I hope you deliver me. Lord, I hope you do it. Mm-hmm. Lord, if it's your will. Now, if you don't know the will of God,
that's right,
you can't have faith in a full God.
Right.
See, the will of God is important. So your faith will never rise above the knowledge of what you know.
That's right. And the will of God is his word.
The will of God is his word.
That's right. See? And then you might ask God, don't ask like, okay, well, Lord, you did it for them, but I think you might do it for me because you did it for them. No, it's not like that. Ask God in faith.
In faith.
And believe that he'll do it.
For assurance.
For sure.
Confidence in him.
Mm-hmm.
Right. You did it for them. Is that why you can do it for me?
Right. Or because my mother said it.
Right. That's why you can do it. I know you can do it for me because you did it for them. Right. Not necessarily.
Right.
You know, the one with the issue of blood, mm-hmm. many was touching him in
that
prayer.
Sure was.
Really?
Yeah.
And, but only uh-huh. she only wanted to receive.
Receive, right.
Because he turned his, in Mark 5, mm-hmm. When the woman with the issue of blood, mm-hmm. and she pressed through the crowd, and she reached out and touched his garment. And she said, if I'm able to touch his garment, I shall be made whole.
Right.
But of course, as you read the story, she was made whole and delivered mm-hmm. and set free. But Jesus said, your faith made you whole.
That's right.
But others that were around him didn't get it. Not that he was a respecter of persons, but he was a respecter of faith.
That's right.
And so he honored her faith. Mm-hmm. And he said, daughter, thy faith hath made thee whole. Mm-hmm. See, so just because others are around doesn't necessarily mean you're going to get it. And even though she got it, that wasn't a guarantee they was going to get it.
That's right.
Because some of them didn't get it. Mm-hmm. So we see here the distinction. Mm-hmm. But let him ask in faith.
That's right.
Let him ask in faith, nothing wavering. For he that wavereth is like a wave of the sea, driven with the wind and tossed. For let not that man think that he shall receive anything
That's right. That's
from the Lord. Lord. That's direct.
Mm-hmm.
Don't even think you're going to use anything, not even a crumb, not even a smidgen.
Mm-hmm.
And you may say, that's true, that's tough. I mean, that the God we serve a God of faith, and he has given you
that's
faith.
Right.
And he wants you to ask him, but he doesn't want you begging him. He doesn't want you just screaming at him and howling at him and saying how long you've been in this out of that desperation.
That's right.
But he wants you to release faith, and he wants you to believe what you're praying will come to pass.
Right.
So what we're actually saying is that God wants us to ask, but he needs to know how to
That's
ask.
Right. He wants us to ask in faith. But you know what? The whole Bible is God wants us to believe him in faith.
Faith.
Not by what we can see all the time. It's just is that what he said, and he wants us to believe that. And that's what I'm really understanding it more and more as I read the scriptures, that he wants us to believe him in faith, that he's going to do it.
Yes.
You know? And then you have to hear some word of faith to build, to get your faith out right.
Because faith cometh by hearing.
Yeah.
And hearing by the word of God.
Word of God, right.
So we need our faith increased. Mm-hmm. We need to feed our faith.
Mm-hmm.
And we need to grow in faith that we can receive from God.
That's right.
And
so,
please God.
Right. So get around some faith teaching and listen to some tapes in your car around faith. And it'll build your faith up. It'll get you... it'll make you more stronger and stronger of the word of God. And that's
yes.
when your faith starts growing.
Well, you know, we can either settle for emotions and mm-hmm. thrills and feel goods, but we were living like that in the world.
Right.
We were controlled by emotions mm-hmm. and feelings. And that got us in trouble.
It got us in trouble.
So now that we're born again, we no longer mm-hmm. need to live by feelings and emotions, because 2 Corinthians 5:7 says we walk by faith. And not by sight.
Right.
So now we learn that the just shall live by faith.
Mm-hmm.
And we are the just ones, justified.
Right.
Romans 1:17.
Mm-hmm.
So because we live by faith, God said, now, how are you going to live if you don't know faith? How are you going to receive from God if you don't understand faith? How are you going to properly ask if you don't know how to ask? And maybe that's why years ago I was a little despondent with mm-hmm. Prayer, because I said, I'm just howling up, ain't nothing happening. And I had no assurance that something would happen, because all I know is that everybody was hollering and crying and begging. All of them were struggling, trying to get God to do something, hoping he would do something. And mm-hmm. I found that he had already done it.
He already done it.
But he wanted us to connect with what he has already done. He's already healed us.
Mm-hmm.
He's already delivered us. He's already set us
That's
free.
That's right.
And he wants us to release faith. So you need to learn about faith. And it's not just, we're not just talking about church and going through to a church service and having
right.
church and have. We're talking about learning how to walk with God.
That's right.
And how to ask of God. Yes.
It's a lifestyle.
It's a lifestyle.
That's right. And God wants to get involved in our situations.
Everyone.
Everyone.
But let him ask in faith,
mm-hmm.
nothing wavering. Because he that wavereth is like the sea tossed and driven
right.
with every wind.
Mm-hmm.
One day you're up, one day you're down.
That's right.
Next day you're level to the ground. One day you believe, next day you don't. You're unstable in all of your ways.
Mm-hmm.
It brings instability in your life when you don't walk in faith.
Right.
Because you want a consistent life. You want to walk strong and consistent in the faith of God. You want to live by faith every day. You want to receive from God on a consistent basis. Mm-hmm. You don't want to say, okay, I hope God do it again like he did it then.
Right.
I know he did it then, but I wonder if he's going to do it now.
Right,
if he did it then, he'll do it now.
That's right.
See, and what faith does is it launches you
right
out into the deep to receive from God. Mm-hmm. So when we pray the prayer of faith, when he's let the elders of the church pray over him,
mm-hmm.
these ought to be men or women, or mature ones.
That's right.
That are not just with a title,
mm-hmm.
but they're people of faith.
Faith is praying, the faith, the word of God.
They pray the word of God, have faith in what God's word has mm-hmm. said. And God said, when that prayer is prayed over you, I will raise you up.
Mm-hmm.
I will raise you up. See that? And the 15th verse in the prayer of faith, James 5:15. And the prayer of faith shall save the sick. That means deliver the sick,
mm-hmm.
rescue the sick.
That's right.
Right? And the Lord shall raise him up. And if he hath committed sins, they shall be forgiven him. Not only does God heal us spiritually, physically, mm-hmm. but also spiritually. If there's sin in your life, he says, I'll forgive you that.
That's
so,
right.
mm-hmm. And you notice the healing came before the forgiveness of sin came.
Mm-hmm. Because some people think they have to get it all right for God to...
perfect, exactly.
You know, to have faith in God. No, we all mess up. We all come short.
So they think they had to, we had to qualify for the healing.
Right.
You know, I got sin in my life, so uh-huh. God ain't going to heal me.
Right.
You know, even though they pray over me, I got to get this sin out of my life.
They don't know what I did last night, but I know. So I know the prayer is not going to work.
Mm-mm. No, he said no.
God said, don't say that.
You receive it by faith.
That's right.
And you get healed,
mm-hmm.
right? And then, of course, he said, go and sin no more.
Right.
But the fact that, but I'm not going to hold back healing because you are a person who's not saved or born again.
Mm-hmm.
You know, because everybody in the Old Testament, and through Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, Jesus prayed over healing for them. None of them were born again.
Right.
They didn't get born again until
after
died on the cross.
Right.
Right? So he hadn't gone to the cross yet.
Right.
But he healed them. He delivered them.
That's what he sure did.
So he didn't.
Mm-hmm.
Well, you get back because you get that sin in your life. No, God will heal you and deliver you. Now, he wants to sin out.
Because
mm-hmm. he said, and I'll forgive you of the sin. You can receive your forgiveness. Get the whole package. You know, and get healed, get delivered. And if it was something that you were doing in your life that opened the door up to for the sickness.
That's right.
Shut that door.
Shut that door, right. If it's something you was eating
mm-hmm.
or something you was, you know, doing wrong. Or,
right. An act in your life.
An act in your life.
You open yourself up to the devil.
Yeah, you
open and this disease, whatever got in.
Mm-hmm.
Shut that door.
Mm-hmm.
God will forgive and restore. So he's about wholeness. But he's asking for faith.
Mm-hmm.
And then he says in the 16th verse that we can confess our faults one to another and right. pray one for another. Yeah. See,
right.
not only do we confess our shortcomings, our mm-hmm. slips, you know, things, because we're not saying that we're faultless. We have faults. We mm-hmm. make mistakes. We do things wrong. And some things you may want to talk with somebody about.
Right.
You should. If it's bothering you and it's hindering you from receiving,
right.
talk to somebody.
Mm-hmm.
You know, share it with somebody, but share it with someone who's going to pray and not just take in the information. Because
right.
he said, not only do we confess our faults and pray one for another.
Right.
We talk about things, we share things with one another, and then we pray.
Mm-hmm.
Because some people may share something with you that you may say, man, that's heavy. I mean, what? But I don't want to make you feel as though you're the only one thought that or did that.
Did that, right.
You know what I mean?
That's right.
It's still not, grace abounds much more where sin abounds.
That's right. And sometimes you think you're the only one that's going through that. No, you're not. Somebody else that went through it.
Somebody else won. You're not the first one.
You're not the first one.
And you won't be the last one.
That's right. There's nothing new under the sun.
Nothing. But talk
and
confess your faults and your mm-hmm. slips one to another. And this confession here is not like you go to a priest and telling him, you're confessing your sins to him, so that priest will forgive you. We're not talking about
mm-hmm.
that, right? What we're talking about here is when things are bothering you or burdening your heart,
mm-hmm.
and you just need to just get it out. And sometimes you need to share. You know, if something's bothering you about mm-hmm. your life, if you feel depressed or even condemned
mm-hmm.
about something that you did in your life, share it and get it out.
That's
when you expose it and vent and
mm-hmm.
confess it and share it, you just expose the devil.
That's And whoever you talk to about it, I mean, they can help you.
Right.
You don't know what they can do. Just open up your mouth and, you know, something, confess and talk to people sometimes, because some people have gone through what you already didn't go through.
Mm-hmm.
And they can share how God blessed them.
And help them.
Help them, right.
That's why I say, and pray once. So, mm-hmm. And I would suggest you share that stuff, things like that, with people who pray. Because he's saying, pray one for another. We don't just want to confess and talk this, and we had no prayer follow up with it.
Right.
Right?
Right.
So we prayed. He said that, and he said also, when you confess your faults and pray one for another, that ye may be healed. And then that's something that even someone, when you do that and you share with others and you pray, you'll be healed. You both will get free.
Right.
You know,
uh-huh.
Say, I pray for you, you pray for me. And confess your faults one to another and pray one for another. We praying one for another. Mm-hmm. You praying for me, I'm praying for you. We helping each other here, and we all get strong.
Right.
But it's still prayers of faith.
Mm-hmm.
So your faith is here.
That's right.
And that's a beautiful thing when we can pray. Mm-hmm. And just imagine if we would pray about more things than just to try to hold it or let it go.
Mm-hmm.
We come together and we pray.
You pray.
Instead of just constantly gossiping.
Right.
and discussing that. That's just pray. And let's believe God for a change, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then he says in the 16th verse.
Confess your faults.
Oh, yeah.
Confess your faults one to another and pray.
One for another, that you may be healed.
Right.
Then he says in the
effectual fervent prayer of a righteous man availeth much.
The effectual fervent prayer of a righteous man
availeth much.
Now, he is saying here, the heartfelt prayer. And Amplified says something about the heartfelt prayer. That's that prayer is a heartfelt prayer is a prayer that's coming from the heart with sincerity, compassion. It's not based on eloquent words. It's not based on how good you sound, how long you prayed, but it's a heartfelt prayer. And when someone has a heart for you, a desire for you to change, they will put their heart and soul in it.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't mean that they got to just get wild, but it's coming from their heart. They may not be the best person with grammar. They may not be the loudest.
Right.
You know, they may not, because he said the heartfelt prayer of the righteous, the effectual prayer of the righteous.
Mm-hmm.
So may not, he didn't necessarily say the prayer of the pastor or an apostle, but the righteous, a righteous person. And a righteous person is a born-again believer.
Mm-hmm.
If you're born again, if you're saved, you're in right standing with God. That means you are righteous in Him. So that's why he said the effectual heartfelt prayer of the righteous. So you can get a man that's in right standing with God or woman because they're in Christ. They're a new creature. He made us righteous through the finished works of Jesus.
Right.
So he said this is a righteous man. So you don't have to look for the prophet. I mean, if the prophet did, fine. But if the pastor can do it, but it's not limited to him. He said, the prayer of the righteous. So if you're born again, if you're in the kingdom of God,
right.
You are righteous.
We're righteous.
In Christ. So the prayer of the heartfelt prayer of the righteous avails much. It's a powerful thing that happens when they pray, when that individual prays, because he's in a position.
Mm-hmm.
He's been authorized by God to make declarations from the earth and pray for you. So it could be grandma. It could be Aunt Sally. A lot of us are sustained today by the prayers of the righteous. Well, it wasn't always a pastor or a bishop prayed over us. It was a grandparent, a mother or father or parent. Somebody prayed over you
right.
And prayed for you because they were in right standing with God. They didn't have a title. They probably wasn't even in the fivefold ministry. But they had a passion and had a heart for you. And they were concerned for you, and they prayed for you, and their prayers were powerful. As a matter of fact, you're going to Amplify. Read me through what that verse is, 16 in the Amplified.
Confess to one another, therefore, your faults, your slips, your false steps, your offenses, your sins, and pray also for one another, that you may be healed and restored to a spiritual tone of mind and heart. The earnest, heartfelt, continued prayer of the righteous man makes tremendous power available, dynamic, and it's working.
It's dynamic and it's working.
Mm-hmm.
And it makes tremendous power available.
Right.
See that?
The earnest, heartfelt.
The earnest,
heartfelt.
Continued prayer
of the righteous man.
Of a righteous individual. Turn. It's dynamic and it's working. It caused things to change. It caused things to get back in line.
Right.
It's tremendous in its power and it works. It changes things. Faith behind that prayer. Faith in the heart of the righteous man availeth much. It causes things to change. It delivers us. It sets us free. Because it is not that they prayed so long or they prayed so powerful or they were so educated, but they were in right standing with God and they were people of faith. And they prayed the prayer of faith. Mm-hmm. They prayed in faith. And faith caused God to move.
That's right. And their heart was right.
And their heart was right towards you, towards God, sincere.
Right. Mm-hmm.
See, and that made a difference. Right. You know, and I'm telling you folks, as we look at this, you don't just say, okay, pray for me, pray for me. We say that casually. But you really want to know that you have people in your life around you that praise the prayer of faith. When you say sometimes they may say, I want somebody who can get a hold of God. Well, what you're saying is that you want someone that can receive from God.
God, right.
And God will hear.
Mm-hmm. God will hear what they're saying.
And he hears prayer of the righteous.
Because they're
faith. He hears their cry, right. Mm-hmm. And they want people of faith.
Faith, right.
Mm-hmm. You know, because I don't need nobody over me just praying, oh, Lord, if it's deliver Don, and if you want to keep him in this thing, keep him long. I don't know what you want to do with him, Lord, but if you want him healed, heal. If you want him, no, I need some, there's no faith in that.
That's no faith, right?
Faith is positive. Faith is direct, and it says what God's word says. So with the prayer of faith, praise the word of God that comes from faith.
Mm-hmm.
See, so Lord Father, you said the believers will lay hands on the sick and they shall recover.
That's right.
I believe that because you said it. So I release my faith in what you said, and I lay hands on this individual in Jesus' name.
Jesus.
And I thank you, they are recovering.
Mm-hmm.
You are raising them up.
That's right.
From that situation.
Mm-hmm.
And I thank you, it's done.
Right.
Thank God for the oil.
Right.
He didn't say the oil will raise them up. The Lord will raise them up.
Right.
It's your faith. But if we have the bottle of oil and there is no faith there, then the oil can't do it.
No.
Faith must be released. Now, oil is a point of contact.
Mm-hmm.
But the contact we make is with faith. That's how we contact God.
And then believe you see them, you know, better. Believe you see them well. Believe you see them coming out the hospital. You know, you see them walking around. You see them, you know, healed, right?
Yes.
You see, you know, that whatever you pray, the situation you pray to them about, you see that.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
I believe in that, and that's how faith works.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, I tell you, I enjoyed the program today.
Mm-hmm.
And we just want to encourage you to know that faith is important.
Yes.
And it's not about how long you pray. It's not about so much of how you sound.
Right.
But it's about what you believe.
What you believe.
Pray the word of God. Believe what the word of God says and release your faith. And the moment you're ready to release your faith, that's when you begin to pray. So, Father, I'm not going to ask until I ask in faith. I'm not going to ask in desperation, fear, or begging you, because you already want to do it. You just want me to connect with you.
That's right.
And you want me to ask in faith. So I'm going to pray the prayer of faith. I pray it over my life. You pray it over your family, your marriage, your children, everybody. You say, I'm praying the prayer of faith over you right now. Why? What is the prayer of faith? A prayer that's prayed in faith.
Mm-hmm.
That's what it is.
That's what it is.
Amen.
That's right.
Well, I believe, praise God, we've done our part for the day. Amen. And God has blessed us with a wonderful day. And I don't know exactly what day you are viewing this. You might be viewing it Sunday. It could be Monday. There's no distance in the realm of the spirit. But the word of God is always fresh. It's always great. And I thank God for you. And we thank God for the household of faith family. We thank God for the body of Christ.
Mm-hmm.
Let's continue to pray for one another. Let's pray for our nation. Let's pray for all of those that are in the world. Let's pray for our cities that we're in, because the prayer of the righteous availeth much.
Right.
So we're going to close in prayer today. And as we're closing, also, we want you to continue to subscribe to our channel. I mean, just keep viewing it and share this with others. Share this news.
Mm-hmm.
People need to hear some good news on top of every other news.
That's right.
Let them hear the word of God. Let's keep the word of God going, because if ever a time we need to pray now, but we need people armed that will pray the prayer of faith and believe God. Amen. Father, we thank you for every viewer. We thank you for every person who's viewing today that's listening to this program and watching it. Lord, we thank you that whatever they're believing you for, we join our faith with theirs. And you said in Matthew 21:22, all things we ask in prayer believing, we shall receive. So I'm asking you to raise those up from their beds of affliction, deliver them from destruction. Lord, I thank you, you're the God who supplies every need. I thank you they're not lacking anything in their lives, but every need is supplied over and above. And we thank you for it in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. God bless you.
God bless you.
And we'll look forward to tuning in again.
You think you can pray after that mistake, but I know it's the only way you can make it better. And I know situations get too much for you to take, and you feel like you gon' break, and it makes you say, I can't take it. Ooh. Well, things get better. Ooh. I'm so frustrated, but it's gonna be